Heights, speed and adrenaline, the perfect mixture for an exciting roller coaster. Thanks to physics and engineering, all this is possible, but since most people tend to not like getting stuck in a car, a lot of calculations need to be done prior to construction. Let's evaluate a model of a roller coaster, which I visualized in the game Planet Coaster. In this simulation, the cart will start on a hill with an initial speed of 7 km per hour and will then make a drop of 41 meters. According to equations of potential and kinetic energy, the total amount of energy at the top of the hill is equal to 1.4 megajoule. The same calculation can be done for the part after the drop, where the cart reaches a speed of 100 km per hour. This will result in an energy level of 1.3 megajoule. So in this drop, 4% of the total energy has been lost. Where did that go? Well, two things, drag and friction. Let's assume that all the energy has been lost due to drag. If that's the case, the drag coefficient can be calculated with this formula. The hard part about this formula is that the path traveled is a curve and the speed of the cart is not constant. I made a spreadsheet to calculate both S and V, but I'll explain that in another video. If we can assume that I did that correctly, we can see that the drag coefficient is about 3.14. If that 4% of energy was lost due to friction, a similar calculation could be made. As a first approximation, we could assume that the friction is only present because of gravity. If that would be the case, this complicated formula would simplify to this one, with d, the horizontal distance. This would result in a friction coefficient of 0.09. But this assumption is not entirely true. Besides a gravitational force, the centripetal force also has an impact on friction. In our scenario, the so-called normal force would therefore decrease a little in the first part, but increase a lot in the final part, which will result in significantly more friction. As mentioned earlier, friction and drag are together accountable for the energy loss. So we could say that if the drag is the reason for 17% of the loss, friction will be responsible for the remaining 30%. Centripetal forces are also the reason loops are possible. In a loop, the normal force should always be greater or equal to zero. Using this information and the speed the cart has before entering the loop, one can calculate its maximum height. Besides all these energy levels, there is also the concept of g-forces. Calculating these is a bit more complicated, but in this diagram you can see the limits of tolerance of a human body. And believe me, you definitely want the g-forces to be below this when you are designing a roller coaster.